Good morning, Geek Ronin Nation. What is up, everyone? I am, of course, Stardust Samurai, your Seder host, with the most, bringing you a little bit of what we do here. Powered by Sriracha, supported by GameStop, and sponsored by Geek Elite Gaming Network, We Bleed Geek. Playing with, of course, the best in the biz, from Elder Scrolls Online to World of Warcraft to CSGO, Call of Duty, Black Ops, Battlefield, Destiny, DayZ, and so fucking many more. I'm not even going to try to list them all. I mean, it's just, if it's a multiplayer game, we've got a guild, a crew, a clan, a posse, whatever it may be. Dragons of the Black Gaming Guild, established 1976, born in the arcades, long before you were even sperm in your daddy's nutsack. That's right, folks, I am in the rounding out of my third decade of life. Yes, I'm a whopping 39. Much older than most of you kiddies, that's the thing. For all those 20-year-olds who call me old, I look at those 20-year-olds and think you're infants. You're little teeny babies of immature lack of experience and not dipping your cock in the pussy. No pussy, no talking. Anywho, folks, it is, of course, the return of Weedness Days. Warrior Weedness Days. That's right, Warrior Wednesdays are back, the return. Now, normally this is for my hunter. We also do Warlock Wednesdays, but that's not going to come back for at least 4 to 6 weeks. And we do other games, of course, other games, let's see. We're going to start off with finishing what we started yesterday, and that's A March of Fires. It's a solo to get my hammers. We're going to get going here in just about a minute or two. We already have arms deals coming in. We're going to swap over to our $299/$300 Hunter after this, collect our arms deals, and see who's online. But until we have one or two people to do the Nightfalls, go into the Crucible and grind things out in 41, we're going to come back to our Titan and keep working on her. I don't want to juggle three characters right now, but I really needed to get some inventory out of my vault. I had a collection of weapons and armor, and I told myself that 4 to 5 weeks, 1 month to a month and a week in, or by the time they launched the hard raid, I would start grinding up my Titan. And so I have to keep my word, because that's what the Sage does. Anyways, folks, enjoy the GGR. We have some Queens of the Stone Age playing today. I'm going to finish getting the studio set up. It'll take me about a minute. It includes taking a piss and smoking a bowl, so it won't be that hard of a job. I'll be right back. Enjoying the day as always. It's a beautiful day here in California, the Bay Area, represent 415 in the hizzy, home of Twitch, YouTube, Google, Amazon, and everything you yearn to be addicted to and strive to be popular in. Home of Twitch TV. But don't forget, we're broadcasting across 6 networks right now. You can find us on StreamMe, Dailymotion, Hitbox, Game TV, YouTube Gaming, and of course, right here on Twitch TV. The one and only live home interactive place for me, because I don't fucking interact with the chats. You can follow me on those other ones. I won't know. It doesn't matter, ho. It's all about Twitch TV, don't you know? And as always, we are a 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365, sometimes 366, days a year, charity streamer. If it's not a charity we're following and supporting yet, it will be eventually. But do not mistake our donation key and our donation drive to keep the stream alive for another year and move on to the PlayStation 4 with Grand Theft Auto, Minecraft, Destiny, and more. including Fallout 4 and Elder Scrolls Online. It is separate. So if you want to donate to me, myself, and I, and keep the show alive for another year and upgrade to the PS4, then hit the donation button at the top of the screen. If you want to give to one of the charities down below, ARMS, VA Services, Breast Cancer Research, Rebuild Nepal, and many more on there, and many more coming this week. We have about 10 new charities we're going to put on there, including Save the Sumatran Orangutans, Re-Preserve the Rainforest, and Stop the Ivory Harvesting on the Asian Hornbill. A lot of eco-friendly stuff, for I am a hippie at heart. And we're going to get this going on. Now, this is a solo mission. Otherwise, I would pull in two of my Holo Yolo boys, but I can't. So we're going to take off on this in just a second. Don't forget, we are about T-minus 15 minutes away from the server reset. I'm kind of tempted not to start this till after the Arms Day server reset at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time here in California. Get some smoke in this lung. I have two. So we need this shit on. We also part of $1,000. Yes, PS4s do not cost $1,000, folks. It roughly, we need about $1,000 a year to run the show. Last year's was going toward, you know, computer upgrades and stuff like that. But this year we're going for a PlayStation 4. Games on there, including Destiny, Grand Theft Auto, Minecraft, Elder Scrolls Online, Fallout 4, Far Cry 4, Far Cry Primal, but also Battlefield 5, Battlefield Online, Borderlands Online, and future games coming over the next 2 years. On top of that, we need a new camera. Oh, shit. All right, enjoy.
What does it mean to be a Titan? As a Titan, you are part of the city. In a way no warlock or hunter could understand. The dream of the city rests upon our shoulders. Then there are those that find a path outside our walls. Those that take up with leaders they barely understand. So it has ever been with the Sunbreakers. The Hammer of Soul is a flame in the darkness. But fire burns without thought. It is time that fire came home. To keep the city and her walls warm throughout the long night.
Booyah. We got some fat grape ape in the house today. So we're off to find the Sunbreakers, a rogue Titan clan.
A legion of Sunbreakers was spotted near a Bex gate in the Ishtar Sink. They do not stay in one place for long.
Right here, I was just trying to have my highest light possible. It's not my my preferred setup. Let's go with... Yeah, I leveled up and got another one. But it's okay, because I don't want just the one. If it has a good roll on it, it's worth it. Let's go with Havoc Pigeon. I'm going to try out the Gemini. You know, I don't have enough hands-on with it to really say otherwise. I do prefer full auto, but if I'm going to be using... Sorry, folks. This weird smell in my house, and I have to say, it smells almost like sewage, you know? I'm kind of worried. I'm a plumber. But it also could be like the jasmine bush next door. Sometimes it gets a little... sweetish kind of fermented smell. And then there's also fucking, I just sprayed this like Dr. Myers like room odorizer in the house, and I'm wondering if that's what it smells. It doesn't smell bad, it doesn't smell good, it doesn't smell like, I don't know. It smells like a
I'm
fart.
I'm detecting what looks like a Sunbreaker's beacon, but it's interlaced with Vex feedback.
Thank you. Now, I've got, like, I think the armor bonus on this. So it's kind of like weapons and armor of light for a Titan. This gun seems like it could almost be used with a Defender Titan. Pretty overkill.
Osiris, find out where they've gone, Guardian.
We need to go to Mercury.
We're heading for a next gate.
I know it's old and most people know, but there's a ghost. Well, I'm not pointing, but there's a ghost right there. I'm playing around with my control settings too. I'm curious what's the best? Overloose? Oh, nice. So these are the Mala Mala's. And that's the Undying Mind mark. It's actually kind of cool. It's a piece of cloth with a moss tendril hanging off. Got a little blind melon playing low in the background. I just want to see if there's anything to scan over here. These are once playthroughable missions, correct? Or can you play these again? I forget. Because I only did my hunter so far, and I haven't really looked for it. I even forgot where it was and what it was called. Interesting. Hey, did I say that you guys should come out? So the Mallow's Maulers, like, once again, those are the Shield Brothers gauntlets. I decided not to really use a lot of motes of light on all this stuff. It's so funny, if you go look at the BungieNet website and inspect my character, those don't look anything like that on there. And then when you go on the Destiny app, they don't look anything like that on there. They just all look different. It's not really better or worse. I gave her it, like, right there too. They look different. They're like way longer than they are in the those look more like they do on the website, like long. I think it's kind of